Cabin Pressure by John Finnemore, starring Stephanie Cole as Carolyn, Roger Allam as Douglas, Benedict Cumberbatch as Martin, and John Finnemore as Arthur. This week, Timbuktu! Do take your time, Douglas. There's still everything to play for. I'm only 26 points ahead of your 3 points. But I have every confidence you're about to come roaring back.
Yes, all right.
But I'm going to have to press you for an answer, I'm afraid.
I don't know. At 20,000 feet, I suppose about 200 knots.
Oh, what a pity. It's a lovely guess, but I'm afraid the answer on the card was 204 knots. I win again, so that's Martin on 29, Douglas still on 3. As we head into round 2.
That was one round.
Oh, don't worry, don't worry. Round 2's much more fun. We say a fond farewell to the flight manual.
Thank God.
And we welcome instead our very good friend, the operations manual.
No. No, I'm sorry, I'm done.
Not a fair pair, Douglas. You promised if I joined in with Flight Deck Buckaroo, I could pick the next game.
But I hate this game.
Yes, and I hate Flight Deck Buckaroo.
How can you hate Flight Deck Buckaroo? It's a terrific game. And it's educational.
There is nothing educational about seeing who can disable the most instruments without setting off the recorded warning.
Yes, there is. You find out all the things you don't really need. Like altimeters.
Now, this is educational. So, welcome to round 2 of Beat the Manuals.
Hello, chaps. Any teas or coffees?
Oh, thank God.
Oh, sorry, Douglas. You should have run.
Actually, we're fine, Arthur. We'll be landing in 20 minutes.
Oh, righto. Oh, and a message from Mum. She says, how long until we land?
Right.
Drivers, how long till we land?
I'm asking the Mum.
Not quickly enough.
Just started the descent, Carolyn, so about 20 minutes.
Excellent. Now, Douglas, I'm having lunch with Herc. Can you give Arthur a lift home?
Sorry, happy though I always am to pick up the pieces around your hectic love life, I'm afraid as soon as we land, I'm driving to Twickenham. I've got tickets for the Rugby World Cup final.
Cup final? But doesn't that mean it's Birling Day?
Oh, Carolyn, haven't you told him?
Told me what?
Arthur, there isn't going to be a Birling Day this year.
What? Why not?
Because this year the final is in Twickenham.
So?
So, Mr. Birling lives in Sussex. To get to Fitton, he would have to drive through Twickenham. And while he certainly has more money than sense, I don't think anyone has that much more.
Oh, no, I love Birling Day.
Me too.
Do you?
Well, no, but I could do with the money.
True. And I wouldn't say no to a free bottle of Talisker.
The bottles of expensive whiskey I provide for Mr. Birling's exclusive use are not free, Douglas. They are stolen from me.
And therefore free to me.
Fitton Tower, this is Golf Echo Romeo Tango India, established on the ILS.
Hello, hello. Is it a bird? Is it a plane? No, it... Oh, no, wait, it is technically a plane.
Hello, Carl.
Fitton Tower, please confine air traffic communications to standard phraseology.
Yeah. Wind at 280 at 8, runway 36, clear to land, all the usual jazz.
Roger, clear to land, 36.
So, did you have a lovely time in Luton?
How could one not? It's a palace of pleasure.
I mean, seriously, you're really not meant to just chat on this thing.
Sorry, Martin. Oh, one last thing, though. Did any of you order a furious posh man?
What?
Only one's arrived for you. Very cross, very drunk. Phil poured him into your departure hut.
Lounge.
Sorry, lounge. Anyway, hope you like him. Ta-ra.
That sounds like Mr. Birling.
It does rather, doesn't it? By the way, cabin crew, prepare for landing.
All right, I'll go and...
Too late.
Mr. Birling!
Ah, there you are, at last.
What are you doing here?
What am I doing here? The question is, what were you doing not being here before now, eh?
But we're not expecting you. You don't have a booking.
Booking? Don't need a booking. Where else are you like going to be? On another job?
Well, yes.
Don't be silly. Now then, now you're finally here. Listen, Timbuktu.
What about it?
Is it a real place?
Yes.
Ah, told you so, stupid woman.
I beg your pardon.
I don't mean you're a stupid woman, you silly woman. I mean my awful wife. Have you met my awful wife?
I have met your wife, certainly.
Well, that'll be the awful one. I've only got one. I may be a fool, but I'm not a damn fool.
No, I'm sure you're not.
And anyway, I'm not a fool. I knew where Timbuktu was, didn't I?
Did you?
I knew it was somewhere. That's the point. I knew it wasn't made up like some people thought it was, naming no wives. Where is it anyway? China or somewhere stupid?
It's in Mali, in the middle of Africa, on the edge of the Sahara.
God, is it how ghastly. Well, can't be helped. I want you to fly me there.
To Timbuktu? Why?
Firstly, none of your business. Secondly, to watch the rugby.
But the rugby is in Twickenham.
I know the rugby's in Twickenham. I told my awful wife it was in Twickenham, and she said I had to stay and see her awful friends when they came round for her awful thing. And I said I wouldn't, and she said I must, and I said I wouldn't, and she said I must, and I said I wouldn't.
Yes, I believe I've picked up the ebb and flow of the debate.
And in the end, she said I could watch it in Timbuktu, for all she cares, so I'm going to.
You're going to fly to Timbuktu to spite your wife?
That's the idea, yeah. Fly to Timbuktu, take a picture to show awful wife who's boss, i.e. me, I am. Find bar in airport, cheer on Wales, the glorious victory over the Itais, get drunk, fly home.
Well, I can ask the crew if they would be willing to consider giving up their day off
Can't we skip all that? I'll give them a couple of grand each and pay you double whatever you were going
to
charge.
You should be ready to leave within the hour, sir. All right, how are we doing? Where are the others?
Fine. Martin's panically filing a flight plan, and I've sent Arthur into Fitton to buy a book about Timbuktu.
What on earth for?
He's in a helpful mood.
Yes, but why do you need a book?
I don't. I need a temporary absence of Arthur in a helpful mood. And I have just given away a ticket to watch the cup final in Twickenham in order that I can fly 2,500 miles to the heart of Africa and watch it there.
Oh, dear. Did the poor little pilot have to fly an aeroplane? You're getting paid, aren't you? Plus an enormous tip.
I know. And a bottle of Talisker.
No, not a bottle of Talisker.
We'll see, shall we?
No. I mean, there won't be any Talisker to steal. I have to order in the 25-year-old stuff specially, and there's no time.
Oh, well, in that case, perhaps I can help. I happen to have a few spare bottles knocking about. For some reason.
Oh, well, that would be very useful. Thank you.
Shall we say £200 a bottle?
What? No! I'm not paying you for the whiskey you stole from me in the first place.
Guys, there's a problem.
Then solve it.
I can't solve it.
Have you tried to solve it?
No.
Then you don't know if you can solve it, do you?
There's a civil war in Mali. So Timbuktu's closed to all air traffic.
Right, so you can't solve it.
Thank you.
Douglas, can you solve it?
I appreciate your faith, Carolyn, but I'm not sure even I can broker a peace deal in a civil war. Not in time for kickoff, anyway.
Fine. I knew it was too good to be true. Who's going to tell Burling?
Oh, wait, hang on. We can't just give up.
You're the one who said it was insolvable.
By me, not by you two. There must be something we can do. Oh, I could really use that 2,000 quid.
I know. But what can we do?
Well, I don't suppose there's anywhere that's a bit like Timbuktu.
What do you mean, all so famous for being far away?
No. I didn't mean that. I mean, like, it... as in, looks like it, a bit. If you didn't really know much about Timbuktu.
Martin?
No, I know, I didn't mean it. I'm just trying to, you know, come up with ideas.
No, Martin, that's inspired.
Is it?
You're a genius. An unexpectedly evil genius.
You mean, you know somewhere that we could...
Oh, plenty of places. There's a little airfield on the island of Sardinia, for instance. Gospini. It's perfect. It's on the edge of the second biggest desert in Europe. And the chap who runs it, it's an old friend of mine.
Of course he is.
A couple of €100, and I'm sure he'll be only too pleased to be Timbuktuan for an hour or two. 300, and the engineers can probably knock up a welcome to Timbuktu sign.
No, but that's fraud.
Isn't it, though? That's why I'm so delighted you suggested it.
I didn't mean... I wasn't seriously...
Oh, don't spoil it!
Douglas, look, it's a nice idea, but we cannot possibly...
Look, Burling's always roaring drunk by the time we land, anyway, and all he wants is a room to watch the rugby in and a sign saying, Welcome to Timbuktu, both of which Sardinia can provide, and neither of which, incidentally, Timbuktu can provide.
But won't he be a bit suspicious that everyone speaks Italian?
Why would he be? Mali was under Italian rule for decades.
Oh, was it?
Of course not. But if you didn't know that, why would he? It's a great idea, honestly.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.